Welcome to Paul's News on the Go, brought to you by the Agriculture Development Bank.
A combined team of police and military personnel, led by the Inspector General of Police, John Kudalor, has begun an exercise to flush out activities of the Fulanis in Agogo in the Asante Akim North Municipality of the Ashanti Region. The operation will focus on evicting wandering Fulani herdsmen rather than those who have registered with the District Assembly and regularized their staying. A five-member Supreme Court panel has, by unanimous decision, dismissed Justice Paul Dery's suit, which sought to declare as null and void proceedings instituted by the Chief Justice to remove him and several other judges who are alleged to have taken bribes. Justice Dery in his suit cited Anas Aremeyaw Anas, the Chief Justice and the Judicial Secretary, for violating his constitutional right by putting out into the public the alleged evidence of misconduct when the issue was supposed to be dealt with in camera. The Supreme Court held that even though Tiger IPI did violate Article 146, Clause 8 of the 1992 Constitution, it does not mean that the constitutional process to inquire into the petition should be declared null and void. Paul's Business can confirm that Ghana's total oil revenue for the fourth quarter of 2015 dropped by 87% as compared to the total revenue in the third quarter. Ghana recorded a total of over $44 million in oil revenue receipts, according to figures from the Ministry of Finance, representing 87% drop from the third quarter's $341.5 million in oil receipts. The Ghana Football Association Ethics Committee has found Techima City FC and WA African United guilty of bribery and match fixing after investigations into their match day 22 game played at the Damongo Park. For giving and accepting bribe aimed at influencing the results of their league match, the two clubs, that is WA African United and Techima City FC, have been demoted to the next division, Division 2.
And that was your Paul's News on the Go, brought to you by